Fernandinho Tatavian Band of Mission Indians, the People Facing the Sun. This presentation is about the history of the tribe, a sovereign native nation of northern Los Angeles County.
Present. This section covers the present administration, programs, and goals of the tribe. The distinct community of the present-day Fernandinho Tatavian Band of Mission Indians originated in the lineages, villages, and cultures of the period preceding the establishment of Mission San Fernando, from which the natives received the name Fernandinho. Mission San Fernando was established on September 8, 1797, at the village of Achoicaminga, and for years following, enslaved Native Americans from the lineages in the geographically surrounding areas, ranging from present-day Simi, San Fernando, Santa Clarita, and Antelope Valleys. Today, the tribe consists of a voluntary coalition of those lineages bound together by a tribal constitution. The Tribal Administration Office is located across San Fernando City Hall in the city of San Fernando, California. The Tribal Senate is composed of 9 members elected from 2 legislative tribal districts who are responsible with setting tribal policies, creating government programs, and working towards self-determination. The executive branch is the administering body of the government responsible for upholding the Tatavian Constitution, Tribal Code, and ordinances.
The Council of Elders provides important decisions on highly sensitive projects involving cultural resource preservation through expertise in cultural heritage and ancestral traditions.
The administration department is responsible for the day-to-day activities that tie together the many departments within the Fernandinho Tatavian tribal government and the many programs provided to its membership.
The Tribal Historic and Cultural Preservation Department is committed to the protection, preservation, and promotion of the cultural heritage of the Fernandinho Tatavian community. It provides government-to-government consultation services under CEQA, AB 52, SB 18, and other environmental protection laws in order to prevent and/or mitigate potential impacts to its tribal cultural resources.
The Education and Cultural Learning Department is an education and leadership development initiative, which uses non-traditional and traditional American Indian teaching methods while incorporating indigenous values for Native American students. The Health and Social Wellness Department advocates for social wellness in the community through mind, body, and spirit. This department advocates for Indian children in dependency cases under ICWA. The Office of Tribal Citizenship is designated to receive and process applications for Fernandinho Tatavian citizenship pursuant to the provisions of the Fernandinho Tatavian Constitution and laws. The following are the Fernandinho Community Centers and 501c3 nonprofits. Puku Cultural Community Services is a 501c3 nonprofit charitable organization providing services for low-income American Indian families. We offer relief to those in emergency situations, helping in fostering, adopting, and educating American Indian youth and cultural awareness.
Tatavian Land Conservancy was founded in 2018 and holds Tatavian land in perpetuity, preserving a property's unique cultural and environmental values. Land ownership offers increased protection to cultural sites because the TLC owns and manages the land or enters co-management partnerships with like-minded agencies and conservation partners. In addition, it prevents the loss of cultural connection by providing a place where Tatavian people can gather, teach, and learn about their cultural heritage.
Haramakna American Indian Cultural Center is maintained by Puku Cultural Community Services and is filed under a special use permit with the Angeles National Forest. Haramakna celebrates the first 5 nations in the region, including the Gabrieleno, Fernandinho, Ventureño, Kitanamuk, and Serrano.
The tribe generates revenue and supports tribal self-determination through for-profit services. The Fernandinho Tatavian Band of Mission Indians has a corporate and commerce commission. Under this commission, the tribe has established Pasiki Strategies Corporation in 2016. Since its establishment, Pasiki has ventured into renewable energy, affordable housing, luxury cigar lounges, and electric trolleys. These efforts provide jobs and generate short, mid, and long-term revenue to serve the tribe and Los Angeles County.
Historic. This section covers the rich and unique history of the Fernandinho Tatavian Band of Mission Indians.
In the pre-Spanish era, a singular tribe did not rule over what is now known as Los Angeles County. Instead, each lineage was a tribe, and within each lineage, there was a hierarchy of leadership. You can view the lineages written in red. Let's zoom into the village at present-day Encino so that you can see this closely. Each lineage was politically and economically autonomous and maintained sovereignty over its local area. Each lineage consisted of speakers from more than one language and were linked to neighboring lineages through trade, marriage, and social exchange.
The tribe traces its ancestry and kinship network through the mission baptismal records to 26 lineages circled on the map.
There was no collective tribal entity above the lineage because each lineage was sovereign. However, the politically independent lineages were linked to one another through language. The tribe uses the term regional group to represent a group of lineages that are connected because their people speak one or more dialects of a language. Regional groups are written in white boxes on the map. To be clear, these are not tribes. There was no tribal group above the lineage. Instead, the regional groups are confederations of shared ceremonial understandings and practices. The sovereign lineages within these groups share regional ceremonial gatherings as well as beliefs of the afterworld. Breaking down the tribe's name, Fernandinho is a Spanish term and represents the Native Americans of diverse territories who were forced into servitude by Mission San Fernando during the Spanish period. Tataviam is a term for the regional group of lineages that inhabited the lands just south of the Cotonamoc people in present-day Kern County. Today, their people are known as a Tohono Indian tribe. The Cotonamoc word Tataviam translates to the people facing the sun. Pictured to the left is Eugenia Mendez, a progenitor of the tribe and well-known informant to John Peabody Harrington. The tribe continued to actively protect its homelands. In fact, after Mexico passed the Secularization Act of 1834, 40 Fernandinho lineage leaders petitioned the Mexican governor for their village lands.
In addition to the ex-Mission San Fernando lands, tribal captains received land grants held in trust throughout Los Angeles, including Rancho Escorpión, Rancho Encino, Rancho Cahuanga, and Rancho Tahonga. These land grants were supposed to be preserved in the American period under the Treaty of Guadalupe Hidalgo in 1848. However, land in Los Angeles County, specifically areas with natural water sources, became increasingly valuable, and the local state courts were against our ancestors' claim to the land, which made it impossible for the San Fernando Mission Indian defendants to affirm rights to land that would have formed the foundation for a reservation. Further, under the Mission Indian Relief Act of 1891, Federal Agent Frank D. Lewis, the Special Assistant U.S. Attorney for Mission Indians, worked to secure Fernandinho land rights through a land case for nearly a decade. Although the special agent was unsuccessful, Fernandinhos continued their connection to village lands, including tribal captain Antonio Maria Ortega. Antonio came from a long line of leadership. His mother maintained the Rancho Encino land grant for the Fernandinho people until their lineage was dispossessed by a Spanish settler during the American period. Antonio fought his entire life to secure land for his people and was even taken to court in a well-known land dispute case in 1876. The San Fernando village land was sold without the consent of tribal captain Rogerio Rocha, prompting other tribal families to occupy the traditional village alongside Rogerio on June 1, 1876. As a result, the Fernandinho were taken to court by two land developers, former California Senator Charles McClay and Benjamin Porter.
And in 1878, the Fernandinhos were found liable for trespassing. They were fined $500 and an additional $50 for each month that they occupied their own land.
The local tribal community who rallied alongside Rogerio included future Captain Antonio Maria Ortega, whose name is highlighted in the court transcript to the right. Pictured in center is tribal captain Rogerio Rocha, circa 1900 in San Fernando, California. Due to the dispossession of Rocha's land grant, which was held for the collective benefit of the tribe, the Fernandinho Tataviam Band of Mission Indians was not made a federally recognized tribe. After a 30-year battle in Los Angeles, Rogerio lost title to the last remaining land. McClay and Porter began evicting the Fernandinhos, and in 1885, McClay evicted Rocha in the midst of rainy season, dumping him and all of his belongings just outside the city of San Fernando. His wife Maria died of pneumonia immediately. At over 80 years old, Captain Rocha passed away shortly after as a homeless refugee on his own homeland.
After the evictions occurred and some very adverse publicity was circulated about McClay and Porter in the Indian Rights Association brochures, McClay tried to defend what they had done by claiming that they had afforded Rogerio Rocha and his family and others various forms of compensation and alternative residence to ease the pain of the eviction. But it was clear from affidavits that the Indian Rights Association obtained from DeSales, from Rocha, and even from the sheriffs that had carried out the eviction, that no such offers were made. The eviction itself was brutally harsh to Rogerio Rocha and the others who were living on the land, and whose land it had been for thousands of years.
Today, not many people know who we are or realize that we are still here. I ask that you support us and learn who we are as Native people in Los Angeles County and how we contribute to the community, serve our country, and persist even though, truthfully speaking, we were supposed to be erased. Our mere existence alone is a miracle.
Years later, the tribe celebrated Rocha's legacy through an MOU with the city of San Fernando that included land management of Rudy Ortega Senior Park, which is located on a portion of Rocha's property.
The tribe has been practicing its inherent sovereignty regardless of its status with the federal government. In 1971, late tribal captain Rudy Ortega Sr. sent several letters to the BIA in request of amending the tribe's status for the purpose of establishing a reservation. On September 28, 1971, the BIA acting area director responded that it would not be possible to acquire lands without first verifying the tribe's legal status. This communication occurred prior to a formal recognition process was set in place by the BIA. Then, on January 18, 1974, Captain Rudy Ortega Sr. wrote to the BIA in request of five things: an Indian clinic, California Indian Historical Center with a library, souvenir gallery, cultural handicraft center, and school for Indian education. We are proud to share that although our status has not been corrected, we have achieved all these visions of Captain Ortega and our people. On April 24, 1995, the Fernandino Tatavian Band of Mission Indians submits its letter of intent to the Office of Federal Acknowledgement. It would be exactly 20 years before the tribe's petition is formally reviewed under the 2015 regulations.
The Academy of Motion Picture Arts and Sciences would like to acknowledge that tonight we have gathered on the ancestral lands of the Tongva, the Tatavian, and the Chumash.
Our homelands are part of us, and even though acknowledgement by itself is but a small gesture, it is a beginning to a greater public awareness of Native sovereignty and cultural rights, including the federal recognition of our tribe.